What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to My Corvette Life. Today, we're getting back to Project Chuck. We're going to go over our full checklist of everything that we are going to be doing. So let's go ahead and take a look. So right away, before we get too deep into this project, we are going to give the car a bath inside and out. Iona did have a bit of a rat problem about 6 months ago. And it doesn't look like the rats have done any kind of damage to the car, but there is feces and urine on the car. So it's a bit of a biohazard issue at the moment. So I want to get it all cleaned up. As you can see, yeah, pretty disgusting. So I want to get it all cleaned up before my hands are all over this thing and let's just get it cleaned up so we don't have anything to worry about. So I've already kind of started a list here for the Mustang. First thing we need to do is drain the gas. That gas that's in there, if there is any in there, has been in there for at least 4 years, probably longer. We're gonna put new gas in it, and then obviously we're gonna check the fuel pump. If the fuel pump needs to be replaced, so be it. Otherwise, hopefully not. Spark plugs, spark plug wires, also fuel filter, air filter, clean the MAF sensor, clean the throttle body, flush the coolant, check all the hoses and belts. We're gonna be doing a full brake job. Tires, actually, great news. Actually, one of our viewers donated a set of two of them are brand new tires. Two of them are fairly new, but we got a set of good tires for this car and wheels, actually. These wheels are off of a similar generation Mustang, not exactly the same year. So slightly different design, but still the same generation. So those should be a direct swap. Actually, the rear tires are slightly wider than the ones that are on the car, so it's gonna give it a little bit of a nicer stance, so that's cool. But huge, huge thank you to the person who donated these. That is so awesome. Obviously, that is, or was going to be one of the bigger expenses on this project, so that's a huge deal. Can't thank you enough for that. So not only are the tires that are on the car old, they're actually completely, like, there's almost no tread left on them. And actually, there's not even a date code on the sidewall of these tires, which makes me think that these tires are older than the year 2000. If you guys didn't know, in the year 2000, all tire manufacturers started putting a date code on the sidewall of the tires, so you could know which week of the year and what year that tire was manufactured. So for example, if the last four digits of that code were 2315, that means it was manufactured in the 23rd week of 2015. So that's a pretty cool thing. Definitely check your tires. If they're older than, say, probably 6 or 7 years, even if they still got good tread on them, it's probably a good idea to replace them. So for example, on this tire, here is the code. Last four digits are 2820, so that was manufactured the 28th week of 2020. All right, so back to the checklist. We talked about tires. Next is clutch. The car definitely needs a new clutch. I've got a few interior things, mainly the steering wheel needs to be replaced. And then we got the third brake light that I showed you guys earlier. It's kind of spider cracked and it just needs to be replaced. And also one of the tail lights is cracked. So those are the things kind of immediately that I know we're going to be taking a look at. But we're definitely going to go through everything, make sure everything's in tip-top condition. All right, we got the Mustang all cleaned up. It actually turned out really well. It's actually surprising how much you can learn about a car by washing it. You know, getting your hands on every single surface, you tend to notice things that you otherwise would overlook. So let's take a look at it in a little bit more detail. So the engine bay turned out really well, cleaned up pretty nice. Wasn't too greased up, just a lot of rat poop and whatnot. Got all of that cleaned up. This hood lever was brown, so it's yellow now. That's nice. We got that old crusty battery out of there. I've actually already went and picked up a brand new battery. But actually, this is looking really clean. I'm actually really happy at how that turned out. I have noticed that the headlights have some spider cracking in them. I'll take a look and see if we can pick up a set of those for relatively inexpensive. They should be readily available online. They made a million of these cars, so let's go on back. Also, one thing I noticed is the window here, you can see, doesn't line up, and I think that's because the battery's been dead. So the window indexing, you know, normally how when you pop the door open, the window goes down. Well, it's not doing that because the battery's been dead. So anytime somebody opens this, the window doesn't go down. So it's not seating properly in there. And it's actually rubbing on the top there. So you don't wanna tear this up too bad. So being a little careful about that until we get that new battery situated in there. Back end cleaned up really nicely. Like I showed before, the driver's side tail light does have a crack in it, so we're gonna go ahead and replace that. I've already found one online, pretty inexpensive. Third brake light, those are relatively inexpensive. Found one of those online, got that ordered. But overall, it looks, you know, appearance wise, looks pretty decent. We just got to go through it mechanically and see what all the issues are. I've already picked up an air filter, some spark plugs, you know, some of the general maintenance stuff. I'm going to get some oil. We're going to change the oil. We're going to change the coolant. Probably change the brake fluid as well. We're going to put new brake rotors, new brake pads on. Like I showed before, we've got the new tires over here that are going to go on. I'm going to drain the gas here next and put some fresh gas in it and see what happens. Probably if I do end up getting it started, might run some seafoam through it just to clean things up a little bit. And yeah, we'll go from there. So there you go. Project is fully underway now. Now it's time to get to work. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please smash that thumbs up button. If you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button below. And until next time, we'll see you guys later. Take care.